MedCram.
Hey, welcome to another MedCram lecture. We're going to talk about hypoxemia and its five physiological causes. Again, anything with the ending of a E-M-I-A is going to have to be something that's related to the blood. So hyponatremia, hypokalemia, hypercalcemia. Again, it's referring to the amount in the blood. This is opposed to the term that we see a lot, which is hypoxia. The difference here is hypoxia has to do with the amount of oxygen in the cells. That's the target area. But how the oxygen gets to those cells is in the blood, and that's what we're going to talk about today. So what are the reasons why you might have a low oxygen concentration in the blood? Well, there's five different mechanisms for that, and they lend themselves to five different answers on a test, which is why this is very highly testable stuff, and we want to go over it. So high altitude is one of those reasons. We'll go over that today. The other one is diffusion. The next one is hypoventilation. Next is shunting. And then finally, we're going to go over VQ mismatch. And this will take a number of lectures to go over, but I want to talk about where we're going to go with this. So these are the five different reasons for low oxygen in the blood. Let's go over those now. Okay, so we're going to talk about high altitude. This is exactly as it sounds. As you go up a mountain, the amount of oxygen in your blood at the top of that mountain is less than at the bottom of that mountain. That's actually quite intuitive, because you know that as you go up in altitude, it becomes harder and harder for you to do things. So you become more short of breath. And this is something that we can actually experience. People who are going up to Everest base camp notice that they can't breathe as well as they can when they're down at sea level. So what is the reason for that? Well, to find out, we have to look at what is the equation that gives us the amount of oxygen that dissolves into our blood. And so the way we look at that is by looking at the total barometric pressure. The total barometric pressure in terms of millimeters of mercury is 760 millimeters of mercury. This is the way we measure it. This is the air pressure at sea level. Now we know that oxygen makes up about 21% of that. So what happens as you go up in altitude? Does the fractional or partial pressure of oxygen go down? No, it doesn't. What actually happens is the total barometric pressure goes down, and as a result, the 21% of that pressure becomes smaller. Let me give you an example. So at sea level, again, we've got 760 millimeters of mercury. Now, as soon as you inspire this air at sea level into your lungs, it becomes humidified. And this is kind of a red herring we're throwing into this, but you should know that the saturated vapor pressure is about 47 millimeters of mercury. And so right off the bat, 760 minus 47 times 0.21 is equal to 150 millimeters of mercury. So this is the PaO2 available to us at sea level. Okay, so this is at sea level. Now, at 19,000 feet, which is approximately just above base camp for Mount Everest, the total barometric pressure at that altitude is about 380 millimeters of mercury. We subtract the 47 millimeters of mercury from the vapor pressure, and what we come up with is about 70 millimeters of mercury of PaO2. And so here we clearly see that the reason why the PaO2 is going down in the blood is because the total barometric pressure has dropped, not because the FiO2, which is this, has changed. In fact, it is the same. It's the same 0.21. So to review that, high altitude, what we see there is it's a result of a decrease in the total barometric pressure, which is 760 millimeters of mercury at sea level. What we see here is that if we put on 100% oxygen, the PaO2, or the oxygen content in the blood, actually goes up. So it responds, which is good. The other thing that we see here is something called a normal Aa gradient. So what is an Aa gradient? Capital A stands for the alveolus. If you know what a cross-sectional area of a alveolus looks like, and there's a blood vessel going by and a capillary, the Aa gradient, this is the capital A, and this is the lowercase a. It's simply talking about the difference in the O2 here in the alveolus versus here in the capillary. And so if there is a big difference between these two, that must be mean because there's something going on here, or there's a barrier, or there's something that's preventing this oxygen from fully oxygenating the capillary. In this case, there isn't. It's simply a result of a low barometric pressure. And as a result of that, the Aa gradient is normal. So what does the body do in this situation to counteract the low PaO2 in the blood? Hyperventilation. And as a result of that, what we see is the CO2 levels, or the PCO2 levels, the partial pressure of carbon dioxide, actually goes down. And this allows more room for the PaO2. So again, high altitude is a result of total barometric pressure going down. It responds to 100% oxygen. The PaO2 goes up when you put someone on 100% oxygen. In this case, it does respond. The Aa gradient is normal, and the body's response to this is to hyperventilate. This is why you see people hyperventilating at high altitude. It's to get their PaO2 up. Okay, so we're going to talk more about these mechanisms, these five physiological causes of hypoxemia, in the next lecture. Thanks very much.